Suppose a jar contains 15 red marbles and 18 blue marbles. If you reach in the jar and pull out two marbles at random, find the probability that both are red. We can find this probability two ways. One way would be to think of this as selecting one marble, and then without replacement, selecting a second marble, and find the probability that both marbles are red. If we approach it this way, we would use the probability formula given below when events A and B are not independent. So we'll first find the probability this way, and then for our second approach, we'll think of this as pulling out two marbles at one time and use combinations to find the same probability. But to begin, we'll find the probability of selecting one marble that's red and then another marble without replacement that's also red. So from our conditional probability formula, this is equal to the probability of selecting one marble that's red times the probability of selecting a red marble given a red marble has already been selected. Notice how we have 15 plus 18, or 33 total marbles, and on the first draw, 15 of them would be red. So the probability that the first marble is red would be 15 divided by 33, and now we have times the probability that the second marble is red, given we know the first marble is already red. Well, the first thing to recognize is now there's only going to be 32 marbles, because we already selected one red marble out. And there's also only going to be 14 red marbles, since we assume the first marble is already red. So the probability of red given red would be 14 divided by 32. This product would be our desired probability. Let's simplify these fractions before multiplying. Notice how 15 and 33 share a common factor of 3. There's 5 threes in 15, 11 threes in 33. 14 and 32 share a common factor of 2. There are 7 twos in 14 and 16 twos in 32. So our product is 5 elevenths times 7 sixteenths, which would be 35 divided by 176. Let's also write the probability as a decimal and percentage. To convert to a decimal, we divide. So we'd have 35 divided by 176. Let's round to four decimal places. Notice how this would be approximately 0.1989. The 6 indicates to round up. So this is an approximation, 0.1989. As a percentage, this would be 19.89%. Now let's find this probability a second way using combinations. Let's find the probability of selecting two marbles at one time and both are red. So we want to find the probability of selecting two reds. The total number of ways of selecting two marbles, because there are 33 marbles, would be 33 choose 2. And notice how there are 15 red marbles. So the favorable number of ways of selecting two red marbles from 15 red marbles would be 15 choose 2. We can also write these combinations as 15 choose 2 divided by 33 choose 2. This is the notation our calculator uses, and we are going to evaluate this using the calculator and make sure we do get the same result. So our numerator in parentheses will be 15 choose 2, so we enter 15 math arrow over 2 probability and select option 3 for a combination, and then we enter 2. So there's our numerator of 15 choose 2 divided by our denominator of 33 choose 2. So in parentheses, we'll have 33 math probability option 3, and then 2, close parenthesis, and enter. And notice how this does give us the same probability as we have here. If we press math enter enter, it will convert to a fraction, 35 over 176. So if you haven't learned about combinations, we should still be able to determine the probability using this approach here. We have our exact probabilities here, and we have the approximate probabilities given here as well as here. I hope you found this helpful.